midst among the stars, thence will I bring thee down, saith the Lord. And you look at the Apollo 11 patch. 11. Look at that patch. Here is an eagle landing on the moon with a twig in its claws. Whenever you see a bird flying around with a twig, it is building a nest. That's what it's doing. And it just stuck out in my mind that the Apollo 11 patch was directly related to Obadiah, verse 4. So, I have questions. I have questions, and I don't need to see, nor just for anybody in the Department of Defense or Homeland Security or anybody else that may be watching or listening, I do not have photographs in my possession. The guy didn't hand me a disk, which at that time would have been either a 1.4 megabyte floppy or a CD. Okay? He did not hand me a disk. More than likely a 1.44 megabyte floppy disk. He didn't hand me anything. I don't have pictures. I don't need pictures. What I need is Bible. Scott says, sounds like Transformers 3 movie. I just started watching that. And it's already got my attention. Watcher says, Watcher Doyle in the Netherlands says, did Jesus make the moon the lesser light? Yes. That's what the Bible says. Okay. Casey says, maybe they're setting up something to help Antichrist show his fake powers to the rest of the world. Good one. Scott says, moons 11 times in KJB, moon 51 times. I'm going to have to corroborate that independently. But I appreciate it. That's a good idea. Oh, boy. Teresa says, oh, boy, now all of your listeners will be watched as if we're not already. Okay. She says, LOL, so I know she's kidding. Let's see here. All right, Marianne. Okay. She said, Marianne, I'm going to be real nice about this. Okay. She's giving some evidence about Apollo 11 not actually going to the moon. I believe they did. I believe Apollo 12 did. I believe Apollo 13 didn't quite make it, although there may be something up with that. The numerics of Apollo 13 really interest me. Apollo 14, 15, 16, 17, I think they all went to the moon. I think they did. So I don't necessarily question that. I know historically, and we know for a fact, that when Armstrong set foot on the moon, or actually when him and was in the capsule before they stepped foot on the moon, they had a Masonic communion service on the moon. We know that happened, okay? And so I believe that it did actually take place. John says, thank God that you're a true believer. I believe the Bible, John, is what I believe. Robert asks the question, Mike, why did they have to bomb the moon one day? They bombed a crater for some reason and nothing happened. I don't know. And I'm going to have to do some. I don't know that actually happened either, but I'm going to do some research on it. Watcher says, "Is the moon a symbol of Lucifer?" Let's go to one more place here, and it's 2 o'clock, but let me read this in Genesis chapter 1. And I will tell you that I firmly believe, according to the scriptures, that the celestial bodies are pictures or representations of the spiritual world, because they were created on day 4, and we know what that number 4 means from scriptures. You have principalities, powers, rulers of darkness, spiritual wickedness in high places. And then, of course, my mind is going, somebody sent me a thing the other day from the MTV Music Awards where Lady Gaga is performing on stage and she's standing on a moon. She's standing on the moon performing. That's Revelation 12 to me. I get that. In Genesis chapter 1, verse 14, and God said, let there be lights in the firmament of the heaven to divide the day from the night, and let them be for signs, for seasons, for days, and for years. Four things here. Let them be for lights in the firmament of the heaven to give light upon the earth, and it was so. And God made two great lights, the greater light to rule the day, and the lesser light to rule the night. I believe that we are children of the day, and I know who the greater light is. Amen. This sun, capital S-U-N, of righteousness, rising with healing in his wings. I think I know who the lesser light is. And when you look in, I think that lesser light is Lucifer, or represented as Lucifer. He rules the night. And if you want a picture of that, go to Romans chapter 16, where Paul said, "May the God of heaven bruise Satan under your feet shortly." When you look in Revelation chapter 12, you see this woman, who I believe is heavenly Jerusalem, who is the mother of us all. She is about ready to give birth, and she has a crown of 12 stars, but she has the moon under her feet, conquering. Anytime you have something under your feet, you're in charge, okay? Anyway, a lot of good comments. A couple more very quickly. Vern in PA says, "What about Daniel 11:38 and the God of forces or alien God? How should they rule over many?" It's a good question. Tracy says, "The eagle has landed." Wasn't that said when they... Absolutely. The eagle has landed. It was called the Eagle Module, and it was carried by the Columbia, which is the Columbia is a dove. It's a picture of Mystery Babylon. There's so much occultism into this thing, it makes me suspicious. Anyway, all right. Can I be lazy now? Okay. I hope you don't mind. Actually, there's a couple more things I want to do before I head home. Appreciate your prayers. Programming note, I will not be here Thursday. I will be doing this. Okay? And hopefully it's not a butterball. And it won't be at my house. I'm going to somebody else's house. But anyway, can I get you to do me a favor? Pray for my mom. Pray for my mom, who is going to have a hard day on Thanksgiving. And I'm going to miss my dad. Already do. I miss him. And so anyway, pray for our family. Pray for Lindsay, my daughter, and her little baby that's due to be born next month. Lot of medical challenges. Pray for our church, our ministry. Pray for just pray for us here. God will keep us safe. And that God will continue to use us to give. Pray that maybe one of these days I will get the answer here that I'm looking for, okay, on this moon issue. Once it gets me started, I want to know. I want to know. God bless you. And any advice or anything you can send my way, I would appreciate it. God bless you. Beware of the blob, it creeps and leaps.